Maxine's dropping me off right now at the airport. I'm gonna be gone for 6 days, surprising my mom, surprising my cousin, surprising a bunch of people. Just got to the airport.
Love you so much.
And check this out.
Wow.
That wasn't supposed to happen.
Alright, I love you, sweet girl.
I love you. LA, I'm coming for you. Well, so much for getting a Bloody Mary, and so much for buying my dad and my brother anything Ohio. Why is everything closed? No, like literally everything is closed. Nothing's open. First stop, Phoenix, then LA.
Hi, Mama.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Did you miss my face?
Yeah, and tomorrow I'm 26.
I know.
I'm so excited.
I'm gonna be there.
What?
Did you know I was coming for your
birthday?
Is that wild?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
Hi. Say hi to you.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
I love you. Mwah. Did you know I was coming?
No.
Hi, mister.
Theo, say hi.
Hi. Hi.
I love you.
I love you.
Wait. On my way with my Aunt Cassie to surprise my cousin Carly. She's the closest cousin in age. And she has no idea I'm coming. She's been talking to my Aunt Cassie and her mom, talking about how much she wants me to come home, even if it's just for a visit, even though she wants me to move back to LA. Anyways, we're gonna be there in a couple minutes and my Aunt Cassie is gonna film. Where?
For a walk.
That's what we say.
What do you say?
Life's weird, man.
It is weird.
COVID test. So now I wish I would have recorded her doing it. It was just a swab and she put it in her nostril, on each nostril for 2 seconds, and she like wiped it around like this. And now we go through the drive-thru. If you're in LA, we got it done at College of the Canyons and we just scheduled it online. So now we have to put it in this white barrel. Knocks up. Get it, your results in 2 to 3 days. Are you nervous, concerned? What are the vibes?
No, I'm not concerned at all.
Perfect. College of the Canyons parking lot, you guys. Schedule it online. We literally scheduled it this morning and 5 minutes ago we scheduled it. We came here and that was it. Easy. All right, so my family recently said that unless I have a COVID test, that we can't come over. So because of my travels, because Maxie and I have been traveling all over the country. So they're like, we actually didn't even realize that you've been traveling all over the country and kicking it with people left and right. Nowhere else in the country is like wearing masks or being strict about this, and it's kind of true. California is by far the strictest state I've ever seen with COVID. So my mom and I are on our way to get a COVID test, like the one she got yesterday, so that I can see my family. But it's interesting because I've already been to their house, I've already been around their kids, I've already given everyone kisses, but they just had an epiphany, and so here I am.
Giving a COVID test.
Put that somewhere safe. You don't want the liquid to spill.
This one?
Yeah. Okay. Put it somewhere safe. There you go. And then take the cotton swab. Great. Once you close the window back up, you're gonna peel the cotton swab like string cheese. Put it in both nostrils, 10 seconds each. I'll be watching you to see if you're doing it correctly.
Okay.
And then once you're done swabbing your nostrils for 10 seconds each, you're gonna put it into that tube with liquid. Snap off the top. Close the liquid and put it back into the bag.
Awesome. All okay. Right. Should I pull?
Make sure my car's in park.
Yes.
Yeah. Should I pull over?
No, you're good right here. Okay. As long as you just
roll up the window.
Yeah. Thank you.
All right. You heard it here first, y'all. Open it like string cheese, and then. She's counting down for me. Other nostril. Now there's boogers on it. All right, there's legit boogers on it.
Oh, gross. No, so now we have to take it over.
No, I don't.
You don't want your body, your boogers in that bag.
Shake, 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 shake. Put it in the bag. Put my mask back on.
All right, great job. So if you could just drive over there and put your specimen into that white container and you'll have your results in 2 to 3 days.
Thank you so much. Have a good day.
So hopefully that liquid gets rid of my buggers, because that would be really embarrassing. But that's it. So just do like drive-through COVID tests, and if you don't have insurance, it's okay. All you do is you check no insurance, and if you do have insurance, you just put in your number, your ID. Once you drive through, you saw how fast that was. It was under 5 minutes. You'll get your results in 2 to 3 days. If you sign up for text messaging, then they will literally text you a link to your results, which is best case. My mom took hers yesterday, so we should have her results by tomorrow, if not today. Because what sucks is that I'm not getting my results for 2 to 3 days, so I won't be able to go to my family's house. I understand, because Maxie and I have been traveling all over the country since COVID started, well before COVID started, since last August. So I totally understand the fear, but I don't know. I know you can have COVID and there's absolutely no symptoms, but we shall see. Wouldn't it be crazy if I had COVID?
But I cannot sleep with you. What do you think I should do? Should I? I'm here from Ohio. Should I not stay at her house? Like,
I'm not gonna stay.
Actually, all you need to do is just quarantine for 14 days.
Yeah.
If your symptoms is not, if you, unless you have, you couldn't no longer take care of yourself, that's the time you go to the hospital. So if you tested positive and you could no longer. That's okay, let the symptoms come. But if you're no longer can take care of yourself, you're vomiting, diarrhea, you're short of breath.
Well, that I can't take care of myself.
That you couldn't, that you will need an oxygen. That's the time you go to the hospital. Let's have it straight, okay?
I can't sleep at your house.
Yes, you can. I don't want to stay in that house by myself. Why can't you sit in the house? Stay with me.
You can, but it has to be a separate
room.
You can see each other. Your room has to have your own bathroom. You cannot share bathrooms because it's airborne. And if mom goes home, she can't leave the room if you're there. So if she needs to go to a bathroom, or if there's only one bathroom.
I can barely take care of myself. Well, I got one arm.
Let's have this straight, okay? So we can get a good blood
pressure. All right, so the shit is getting wild, man. My mom has COVID. We got those tests and my mom has COVID. We went to the hospital and I got the email after we left my aunt's. I can't even talk straight because I've had such a bad day. My mom's inspection, you can tell I'm exhausted. My mom's inspection for the new apartment did not pass, which is basically a lot of the reason that I even came to Los Angeles. Therefore, I couldn't move her to her new apartment. What, fool? I was shocked, absolutely shocked. Mine was negative and I've stayed with her. Long story short, we went to the hospital and they were like, she has no signs. We took her temperature, we took her vitals. There's nothing you can tell us to make us admit her, because it's just not gonna happen. We're not gonna admit her. So here we are. I'm still with my mom in the car and she has her mask on, but we are going to sleep in separate bedrooms. She only has a one bedroom apartment, so she's gonna sleep in the living room, or I'm gonna sleep in the living room and she'll sleep in the bedroom. And that's where I'm at right now. So no apartment, but COVID. Awesome day. It is, what day?
Friday.
It's Friday. I've recorded some footage from yesterday, but to be honest with you, yesterday was how horrible of a day?
Horrible.
It was a horrific day. Yesterday, we got our COVID results back. I was negative. My mom was positive. I went directly to the emergency room. And if you guys have any conspiracy theories or your thoughts on COVID, comment them down below, because I'm curious. They treated it like it was nothing. I mean, we went to the hospital. I told them that she had COVID. She already has chest problems. She already has heart problems, breathing problems, you name it. My mom is not in the best of health. And they basically said, we checked her vitals, we checked her breathing, and we checked her temperature. She's fine. There's nothing that you could potentially say to us right now that is gonna make us admit her. I'm actually not going back to Maxi till Tuesday. So instead of flying into Pennsylvania, I'm gonna be flying into Brooklyn. Life's weird, man. 2020 sucks. And that's all, period. Woo! My mom and I are in the back of a U-Haul. She's right here. And we just moved her with all of her stuff out of her apartment in Santa Clarita. So cheers to closing that chapter. And I didn't want to have to take an Uber. So my dad's like, yeah, just hop in the back of the U-Haul. And that's what we're doing. And we're off. Taking this to Montrose, which is where my mom's new apartment is. And gotta say, first time in the back of a U-Haul, it's pretty fun. How you feeling over there? Sketch. Very sketch, to say the least. Don't try this at home. We got both of our tests back.
What is it?
Both negative.
Yay! Hurrah, hurrah! I'm so happy.
So how do you feel not having COVID?
I'm so grateful.
Fuck yeah, dudes. Let's party.
Officially on my way back. I'm so excited, you guys. Seriously, I've been here for so long.
Okay, you guys, we're in New York City. I am a total fucking tourist, but I don't even care. Okay, Freedom Tower right here. This is in replace of Twin Towers. Tallest building in New York City. We got some boys over there. Lexi's hungry, so we decided we're gonna get an appetizer. The number one thing I want to do is go to Times Square, so hopefully that'll be tonight. I will keep you guys posted.